In this tutorial, we will be exploring the options available in FME Server to enable users to make their own datasets available for use within a workspace that has been published to FME Server. You can choose to use the options built into the default FME Server web user interface, or create a custom web application on top of FME Server. This tutorial is divided into three sections. Section 1 will be uploading data through the FME Server web user interface. Section 2 is custom web pages for FME Server 2015. And Section 3 will be using REST API. This video will cover Sections 1 and 3. For Section 2, please visit the article page, and the link is in the description. Let's get started with Section 1, uploading data through the FME Server web user interface. We want to be able to update a map weekly to indicate sports field status. This workspace takes a CSV file containing information about whether the field is open to use or closed for use, and combines it with the map info tab file containing park polygons of the city of Vancouver. Field status can change each week, so we want to create a workspace that reads the up-to-date CSV file and generates an updated KML file without having to modify the workspace each time. This can be done with user parameters and FME Server. First, we will need to do some preparation before we can upload the workspace to FME Server. Open the data upload.fmwt template file and expand the CSV reader in the Navigator pane. Right-click on the source CSV file parameter and select Create User Parameter. In the Add Edit User Parameter dialog, click the drop-down menu for the type field and change this to File Name Existing. Change the prompt to Field Status CSV file and change the default to off. Click OK. Notice in the Navigator pane, the cogwheel next to source CSV file name has turned red. This is okay because we haven't added a CSV file yet. Once we add the file, it will turn pink. The parameter we just created can be found under User Parameters, Published Parameters, in the Navigator pane. To run the workspace, first we need to ensure that Run with Prompt is enabled, so that we can add the new CSV file to the user parameter. On the toolbar, click the question mark icon or go to Run, Run with Prompt. Then click the Run button. In the Translation Parameters dialog, browse to and select the Weekend Play Field Status.csv file and click OK. And the workspace will run. Click on the Field Status Writer. Pop-up menu appears. Select the folder icon, which will open up the containing folder with our KML data in it. Then open up the Field Status.kml in Google Earth. As you can see, the workspace added stylings, so that the closed fields are red and the open fields are green. If you click on a park polygon, a pop-up dialog will appear with information about the status, closure notice, and the last updated date. Next, let's publish the workspace to FME Server. In FME Workbench, click the Publish to FME Server tool, or File, Publish to FME Server. In the Publish to FME Server dialog, click the drop-down next to Connection, and select Add Web Connection. Then enter your FME Server credentials. Click Next. Click New next to Repository Name. We will create a new repository named Data Upload Tutorial. Click OK. Notice that by default, Upload Data Files is checked. Take a look at which files are being uploaded. Click on Select Files. The Parks files are from the Map Info dataset. Leave those alone. Uncheck the CSV file at the bottom, because remember, we want the user to provide the CSV file for this workspace. Click OK until you are back to the Publish Workspace dialog, then click Next. Make sure your workspace is registered with the Data Download, Data Streaming, and the Job Submitter services. Click Publish to publish this workspace to FME Server. Now that the workspace is published to FME Server, let's run the workspace on FME Server and upload our CSV file. Open the FME Server web user interface and log in. On the side menu bar, click on Run Workspace. Set the repository to Data Upload and select the check field status.fmw workspace. From the service dropdown, select Data Download. In the Publish Parameter section, there is the field status CSV file parameter that we created in FME Workbench. Click on the ellipses to open the select file for the file's status CSV file dialog. In the dialog, click on the tab Temporary Uploads, then click on the Upload File button. Select the Weekend Play Field Status.csv file to upload, and then click OK. Uploading data this way makes use of the Data Upload service and FME Server. The workspace is now linked to the weekend playfield status.csv file using a publish parameter. Click on the Run button on the Run Workspace page after the CSV file has been 100% uploaded. Once the job has run, a job status page will appear. If the job was successful, there will be a data download URL at the bottom. Click on the data download URL. This will download a zip file containing the field status.kml file. Unzip the file and open it up in Google Earth to view the results. The results can also be viewed in the FME Data Inspector if you do not have Google Earth. Let's look at another method for data upload by uploading a file to the Resources page, then reading that file from the Resources when we run a workspace. Unlike direct upload, uploading a file to the Resources makes that file available for every workspace on FME server. Files uploaded this way will persist by default, but the system maintenance tools within FME server can be used to clear out these files at a regular interval. On the side menu bar, click on Resources. On the Resources page, navigate to the Data folder and click New Folder. Name the folder Data Upload and click OK. In the Data Upload folder, click the Upload button. In the drop-down, select Files. Browse to weekendplayfieldstatus.csv and click Open to add the file. To run the workspace to read the file from the Resources folder, we need to configure the parameters. Click Run Workspace on the side menu bar. Then click the ellipses for the filed status.csv file and navigate to the file we just uploaded, which is in the Resources tab, Data, Data Upload, then weekendplayfieldstatus.csv. Click OK. Click Run to run the workspace. After the workspace has been run, you can download the zip file just as before. The final method for making data available to FME server technically does not involve actually uploading the dataset. Instead, we will tell FME server where it can look to read a file directly from a source location. This could involve putting a UNC path to the network location, or specifying a URL to an external resource on the internet. In a web browser, go to data.vancouver.ca. This is the open data website for the City of Vancouver. Click on View the List of Datasets, then scroll down to W to find Weekend Playfield Status. Click on XML. This will open up a new page with all the XML. Copy the URL. This is what we will use to upload the data to the FME server. Back in FME server, click on Run Workspace on the side menu bar, then select the data upload repository, and check fieldstatus.fmw as the workspace. In the server dropdown, select Data Download. Then for the file status CSV file, paste the URL we just copied from the City of Vancouver's website. Run the workspace and view the data download URL just as before. The final way to upload data is by using a UNC path. In your file browser on your computer, create a new folder called Field Status Data and put in the weekend playfieldstatus.csv file into this folder. Right-click on the folder and select Properties. In the Field Status Data Properties, in the Sharing tab, click on Advanced Sharing. Enable Share this folder and then click on the permissions. Ensure allow permissions are set to full control. Click apply and click OK until you are back to the field status properties dialog. Then copy the network path. Back in FME server, click run workspace and send it to the data upload repository. Set the workspace to checkfieldstatus.fmw and set the data download service like we did in previous examples. For the field status CSV file, paste your UNC path and add /weekendplayfieldstatus.csv. Run the workspace and download the results. This concludes section 1. You should now be able to publish a workspace to FME server with published parameters, upload the data using a temporary uploads folder, create a new folder to upload data for other users to access, use a URL to read in the data, and read in the data using a UNC path. In the next section of this tutorial, we will cover how to create a custom page to upload to FME server.